to the second part of your training. Today, we'll engage in your first aerial combat. However, first things first. You can always change your viewpoint when flying. Usually there are three viewpoints. Cockpit, virtual cockpit, and third person view. Change the viewpoint. Press this button repeatedly to cycle between viewpoints. Choose the one you like best. You can zoom in to see your target better. Often, you'll need to see what is happening around you. For that, you can look around. However, your target might be out of your range of visibility. If that's the case, try to locate it on the map. As soon as you take aim at your target, pull the trigger. Excellent. It looks like you already feel comfortable in the air. However, sooner or later, you will need to land. Fly towards the airport. Now, watch me as I land the plane. Soon, you will have to do the same. First, I'll engage the landing gear. Then, I'll drop the flaps. My speed will start going down, but this isn't enough by itself. I'm lowering the engine power to 30%. There's no need to lower it to zero yet. If I realize that I'll be unable to land for some reason, I'll be able to go around for another try. For a soft landing, the aircraft speed at the moment of touchdown needs to be rather low. My plane is losing speed and descending. I need to level the plane horizontally so that it lands on its landing gear and not on its nose. I'll do this using the elevator. After touchdown, I can use my brakes to reduce speed. I'm lowering my engine power to zero, and then I keep lowering the throttle lever to turn on the brake. Now my plane has stopped. It's your turn to make a landing approach. Follow the marked route. Your approach button is your pre-landing maneuver room close to the airport. It allows you to prepare the plane for landing and position it correctly. First, you need to descend, gradually slowing the plane. Apply the elevator down to level the plane. It should descend in a true horizontal position. Start braking. Lower the engine. to activate the brakes. Excellent landing. Congratulations. You have mastered the hardest part of piloting airplanes. Our country can be proud of a pilot like you. Out with torpedo bombers. They're a key asset in carrier aviation. Prepare to master torpedo launching, which is a difficult maneuver. First, you'll learn to take off from the aircraft carrier. It's a lot like taking off from the tarmac, the only difference being that there's little room for acceleration. So I'm pushing engine power to maximum. I pull the airplane nose up after takeoff, so that it doesn't fall into the water. Only then do I retract my landing gear and flaps. The runway is clear. Take off. Gather speed. The plane is not aligned with the runway. Use your rudder to level it. Continue building speed. Now pull the control rope so that the plane doesn't fall into the water. Try to fly horizontally. Now, retract your landing gear and flaps. Great job. You're in the air again. Follow me. In general, torpedo launching is done according to a consistent scheme. We approach the target, descend, aim, and launch the torpedo. It's important to remember that torpedoes move in a straight line. The further you are from the target, the more chance it has to dodge the torpedo. The optimum torpedo launching range is about 1 kilometer from the target. Now I'll show you how to do it. A torpedo bomber is an easy target for the carrier anti-aircraft gun systems. That's why speed is crucial for us. The faster you fly, the harder it is for them to hit you. Before entering the torpedo run, I'm going to dive to gather speed. Now, time to aim. The torpedo will follow the same course after the launch. I'm aiming the nose of my plane directly at the ship and leveling the plane horizontally. If you launch the torpedo incorrectly, it might go deep underwater or take the wrong course. Now I can launch the torpedo. Right after the launch, I start ascending. There, I hit the target. Now you need to destroy the ship with a torpedo. First, take your position. Now, an altitude of 30 to 100 meters. Level the plane. It needs to be flying horizontally or with a slight down pitch. Under no circumstances should you pull your nose up. Aim the nose of your plane at the target. Do not bank the plane. Need to launch the torpedo no further than 1.5 kilometers from the target. The closer, the better. Surface. Your torpedo will miss the target. Try to perform the maneuver again from the beginning. the seas. Head towards the airfield. Understand that torpedo launching is an efficient but risky maneuver. Be careful in battle. Good luck. Greetings, pilot. Today you will practice.
Attention! Approaching target!
Destroying land and water targets is an important part of any military operation. Horizontal bombing works well for destroying immobile land targets. However, it isn't suitable for bombing moving targets. But these targets need to use dive bombing. practice targets. I'm going to show you the maneuver. Watch me closely. When diving, the plane will gather speed. If your speed is too high, flutter can occur, causing the destruction of your plane. So, first of all, I'm decreasing engine power. However, it's not enough. I also need to activate my speed brakes. I'm flying at an angle of 60 degrees. Steeper diving might destroy the plane. I'm approaching the target at a high speed. But I still have time to aim. Now I'm ready to drop the bomb. There we go. Now, the first thing I need to do is retract the speed brakes. Then all I need to do is level the plane. Watch your altitude. Start leveling the plane in advance to be able to recover from a dive. I think you're ready to repeat the maneuver. Lower your speed. Deploy your speed brakes. Start diving. Pop the bomb. Now, pull the control yoke to level the plane. Time to go back. Let's fly to the Enterprise. I've already mastered landing on the tarmac. Landing on the aircraft carrier is different from landing on the runway. A carrier is a lot shorter. In order to stop the airplane, you need to snag your tail hook over the arresting wire on the flight deck. I'll show you how to do that. Starts as usual. I extend my landing gear and flaps. Now I lower my engine power. Time to align the airplane with the runway. I'm beginning my descent. As I approach the runway, I need to level the plane horizontally. Now for the final stage of the landing. I'm flying level with the flight deck. Watch carefully for the moment of touchdown. That's it. My plane has stopped. Now I'll take off and you'll land your plane. time to maneuver. Make sure your plane is aligned with the runway. Check your speed and altitude. Ready? Go for a landing. Great job. You've successfully completed this task. I'm sure you'll do great in real combat.
Thank you. 18 SBDs took off from the USS Enterprise on a routine scouting mission to fly ahead and land at Ford Island. The Enterprise lay 200 miles west of Oahu and was heading home.
Target. I'll continue patrolling.
On December 7, 1941, Japanese carrier aviation attacked U.S. bases in Pearl Harbor. Several hours later, on December 8, local time, the Japanese attacked Wake Island. On the very first day, bomb attacks destroyed most of the aircraft stationed on the island. The bombings continued for several days. On December 11, the Japanese attempted to land on the island.
Please cut. damaged, but it's too far for the battery fire to finish it. Don't let it escape.
Roger that, sir.
Thank you.
return to base.
Yes, sir. The Japanese won't forget this day. Wig won't be an easy prey for them. I can't see Elrod's plane. Where is he? I see him landing on the shore. Looks like he had been shot down. We got fewer and fewer planes.
The unexpectedly strong resistance put up by the Wake Island coastal artillery and remaining aircraft forced the Japanese fleet to retreat. The island's garrison suffered very few losses. Realizing that the first landing attempt was premature, the Japanese continued bombing the island. Three Wake Island airplanes were launched when the radar picked up approaching enemy planes.
Hi, what's your status?
The unexpectedly strong resistance put up by the Wake Island coastal artillery and remaining aircraft forced the Japanese fleet to retreat.
Thank you.
on fuel. Let's head back. We've had one hell of a day.
It's okay. We can hold it out.
Wake Island, fighting alone, still stood its ground. Two Japanese carriers, Soryu and Hiryu, which took part in the attack on Pearl Harbor, were sent to the coasts of Wake Island to back up the second landing attempt. On December 22, 39 planes were launched from the carriers to subdue Wake Island's resistance.
Thank you. I copy, Lieutenant.
Enemy aircraft in sight. Sector D-12.
Roger that. Taking a course to Sector D-12. Don't attack it alone.
Okay. Meet you in Sector F-12.
Roger that.
Thank you.
I'll distract them. Try to land.
Came back at 12:25 a.m. 33 bombers came in from the west, bombed Peel Island. Sergeant Wright was killed, 4 wounded on the rangefinder. We went out at night and moved the guns into coastal defense position as it was getting pretty hot. December 23, they came back with several ships. We were heavily shelled and bombed.
December the 22nd, 1941. The Americans tried to help the beleaguered island, sending a relief force.
To gain control of the Coral Sea, Japanese command sent a naval force to Tulagi Island. The Japanese were hoping to establish a naval and air base on the island. On May 4th, the aircraft carrier USS Yorktown entered the region. Bombers were launched from the carrier to stop the Japanese landing on Tulagi. Around noon, the pilots noticed several enemy hydroplanes. Yorktown fighters were sent to search and destroy them.
Heading towards the island. Maintain vigilance. The planes that attacked our bombers could be anywhere.
I see them.
The conduct of the air group personnel cannot be praised too highly. In the space of 5 days... On May 6, 1942, after completing the landing operation in Tulagi, the Japanese aircraft carrier Shoho returned to the theater of war. She was followed by ships, which were headed towards Port Moresby. U.S. carriers Lexington and Yorktown, located further south, were searching desperately for the enemy fleet. On the morning of May 7, one of the U.S. pilots detected Japanese ships off the coast of Mishima. Lexington and Yorktown carriers immediately launched an airstrike.
One hell of a battle.
Photographs were obtained. June 4, 1942. Japanese forces start their operation to occupy Midway Island. A surprise attack was key to the operation's success. However, Commander-in-Chief for Pacific Ocean Areas, Admiral Chester W. Nimitz, began preparations to defend Midway several months previously, basing his decision on intelligence data. While Japanese forces were approaching Midway,
guys, the Japanese fleet must be close by.
Roger.
Try to find him. To the right. We'll take care of the rest.
Let's give them hell, guys!
Thank you.
Despite heavy losses, the morning attack was a success. Three Japanese carriers were destroyed. However, the Japanese command still had Hiryu at its disposal. Planes were launched from its deck to start a counterattack. Both Japanese counterstrikes hit the same aircraft carrier. Although Yorktown was dead in the war,
the plan. Just do what we did this morning. Attack with the sun behind us and take their defense by surprise.
Target the carrier and launch the attack.
through the...
Thank you. Thank you.